Hello, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and I've already lost my my poppy somewhere. I knocked it off. I always have a problem with those. Poppies and Remembrance Day are very, very big in Canada, especially in houses like mine, where your father did go overseas to fight in the World War II, and you know, five other brothers were in the army at various times. Anyway, wanted to show you my DVD pickups today. I didn't buy any Blu-rays, I don't think. Yeah, one Blu-ray. Now, we know M. Night Shyamalan gets a lot of shit. He's put out a lot of shit. But for $5, I thought the shit might be worth it. And Ted says that he liked that movie when he watched it on TV. So, we'll see what happens. Ted also asked me to get this because he likes that movie, The Namesake. I think Ted's always had a thing for tall, good-looking Indo-Canadians and East Indians, whatever, however you want to characterize them. And I've never seen Slumdog Millionaire, another overrated movie, I understand, but this was not $13.99 for the two movies. It was actually $6.99. So that's why I got it. And I've looked at these last year, or earlier in the year or something, and they've been reduced again, so they were $16.99. They each have at least four classic movies, and this one here, Anna Karenina with the lovely, the exquisite, the maddening Vivien Leigh, A Farewell to Arms with the lovely, the exquisite, the maddening Rock Hudson, Les Miserables, two versions, 1935, 1952. I think the 52 one, is that the one with the Hunchback, Charles Laughton? Frederick March in the 1932 one. Frederick March and Charles Laughton star in the 1935 version, while Michael Rennie and Deborah Padgett lead the 1952 retelling. And then the Anthony Perkins one was the 60s or 70s. And I'm such a Les Mis fan anyway from the musical. And then the exquisite, the beautiful, the maddening Tyrone Power in The Sun Also Rises. It's a Hemingway story, which I've read more than once. The exquisite Ava Gardner and Earl Flynn are also in it. So that's a pretty good set. I've read A Farewell to Arms, and I've wanted to get that version for a long time because of it. I read it when I was taking one of those graduate humanities courses, and I had to read a shitload of Hemingway and a shitload of Faulkner. So I've read most of their works, actually. Now this one here, they're called studio classics, but some of these aren't classics, but they're awfully fun. Fantastic Voyage. The Lost World, not as crazy about that, but Fantastic Voyage. I mean, that's a fun movie, and that's being remade, I believe, as well. It's in the works. One of my favorite disaster movies, I've been trying to get this for so long, The Towering Inferno, and I sure hope it's in widescreen. I mean, if it isn't, I'll be really choked. The original Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea from the late 1950s or early 60s. I've seen that movie several times, actually quite good. And then they used a lot of the same, you know, scenery. It's Irwin Allen, so he reused his scenery and all the stuff he could get out of the Fox Vault for his TV series, Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea, which debuted in 1964, I remember. So, and here's another one I've wanted for a long time. This is, of course, All About Eve, which I've seen many times, but I don't own. This is Beyond the Valley of the Dolls, not one of my favorite movies. I know it's got a cult following. I never cared for it. In of the Sixth Happiness, which is more of a straight drama, Ingrid Bergman. This is the one that I wanted here. This one and this one. Valley of the Dolls, one of my favorite high camp movies. One of the most exciting experiences of my life seeing that movie. I just love that movie. It is just a camp classic. My favorite bad movie, I think. Didn't I so tell you people that? And Ted saw this. I've been wanting this for a long time, so this is the only Blu-ray, Boogie Nights. He went on a netbook or tablet or something at Best Buy, and it was the review in DVD Digest or Blu-ray Digest or something. He said the transfer was supposed to be awfully good. And don't think it was $22.99. What was it? $9.99. Yeah, $9.99. And then I used my last $20 reward zone credit, so my purchases came to $78.14, and then $20 came off. That's why they give you the credits, because look what you end up doing. So I thought you'd appreciate that. I'm going to go and pause, and I'm going to look up one of them, okay? I just want to see if it's going to be, you know, widescreen. You know, I don't do unboxings as such. But there's the movie I've already shown you, the box. It's actually quite nice. Voyage to the Bottom, or Fantastic Voyage. Lost World. Towering Inferno. Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea. Walter Pidgeon. I see this movie here. This was my favorite disaster movie, and probably still is. I saw that in 1974 when it came out. And that followed the Poseidon Adventure by 2 years. And that's where Irwin Allen finally used, you know, put some money in the budgets. But I love this movie. And one of the most amazing things about it is how Faye Dunaway stayed in her dress throughout that movie. I wonder how many dozens they had. But lovely all-star cast. I mean, All About Eve, Beyond the Valley of the Dolls, The Inn of the Sixth Happiness, and Valley of the Dolls. There's All About Eve, classic, simple, beautiful. Beyond the Valley of the Dolls, very much in keeping with the 70s. The Inn of the Sixth Happiness, basically just 20th Century Fox logo. And this is Valley of the Dolls, and this is very much in keeping with the posters that were put out for that. I remember I went to the show to see this when it opened. 1667 or 68. And love that movie. So let's see if it's going to be widescreen. So, I didn't look up the third one, but I am extremely satisfied with the letterboxing and Towering Inferno and Fantastic Voyage and on Valley of the Dolls and so on. And I'm sure I'll be just as happy with the transfers on these. And the cases, I mean, really are nice. I mean, you've got the slipcover. Yeah, that way. And you've got the same art, same as what's on the back of the box as well. But, you know, it's set up very nicely. I mean, this is a better job, isn't it, than what they did with Star Wars? You know? And then you've got the credits and that on the left side again, right over there. So, I'm quite pleased. So each of these movies cost me $4. Like I say, the transfer upstairs when we're doing the up converting to 1080p from the DVD transfer, it's going to look pretty good, I would think. Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, I'm glad you stuck around. I know that I made some noise there, and I had to delete a bunch of footage where I couldn't see what was being filmed when I was filming the screen. And you know, I got some really, really lovely photographs of the Venetian blind behind the monitor here with me blabbing, so I don't think that was terribly informative, so I cut all that out. Michael from Red Chair Diaries, see you around too.